The Taj Mahal or Crown of the Palace is an ivory-white marble mausoleum on the southern bank of the river Yamuna in the Indian city of Agra. It was commissioned in 1632 by the Mughal Emperor Shah Jahan to house the tomb of his favorite wife, Mumtaz Mahal. It also houses the tomb of Shah Jahan himself. The tomb is the centerpiece of a 17-hectare complex, which includes a mosque and a guest house, and is set in formal gardens bounded on three sides by a crenellated wall. Construction of the mausoleum was essentially completed in 1643, but work continued on other phases of the project for another 10 years. The Taj Mahal complex is believed to have been completed in its entirety in 1653 at a cost estimated at the time to be around 32 million rupees, which in 2020 would be approximately 70 billion rupees. The construction project employed some 20,000 artisans under the guidance of a board of architects. The Taj Mahal was designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1983 for being the jewel of Muslim art in India and one of the universally admired masterpieces of the world's heritage. It is regarded by many as the best example of Mughal architecture and a symbol of India's rich history. The Taj Mahal attracts 7 to 8 million visitors a year, and in 2007, it was declared a winner of the new 7 Wonders of the World initiative. Inspiration. The Taj Mahal was commissioned by Shah Jahan in 1631, to be built in the memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal, who died on June 17 that year, while giving birth to their 14th child, Gulhara Begum. Construction started in and the mausoleum was completed in 1648, while the surrounding buildings and gardens were finished 5 years later. The imperial court documenting Shah Jahan's grief after the death of Mumtaz Mahal illustrates the love story held as the inspiration for the Taj Mahal. Architecture and design. The Taj Mahal incorporates and expands on the design traditions of Persian and earlier Mughal architecture. Specific inspiration came from successful Timurid and Mughal buildings, including the Gur-e-Amir. While earlier Mughal buildings were primarily constructed of red sandstone, Shah Jahan promoted the use of white marble inlaid with semi-precious stones. Buildings under his patronage reached new levels of refinement. Tomb. The tomb is the central focus of the entire complex of the Taj Mahal. It is a large, white marble structure standing on a square plinth and consists of a symmetrical building with an arch-shaped doorway topped by a large dome. Like most Mughal tombs, the basic elements are Persian in origin. The base structure is a large multi-chambered cube with chamfered corners forming an unequal eight-sided structure that is approximately 55 meters on each of the four long sides. Each side of the Iwan is framed with a huge vaulted archway with two similarly shaped arched balconies stacked on either side. This motif of stacked is replicated on the chamfered corner areas, making the design completely symmetrical on all sides of the building. Four minarets frame the tomb, one at each corner of the plinth facing the chamfered corners. The main chamber houses the false sarcophagi of Mumtaz Mahal and Shah Jahan, the actual graves are at a lower level. The most spectacular feature is the marble dome that surmounts the tomb. The dome is nearly 35 meters high, which is close in measurement to the length of the base, and accentuated by the cylindrical drum it sits on, which is approximately 7 meters high. Because of its shape, the dome is often called an onion dome or amrod. The top is decorated with a lotus design, which also serves to accentuate its height. The shape of the dome is emphasized by four smaller dome chhatris placed at its corners, which replicate the onion shape of the main dome. The dome is slightly asymmetrical. Their columned bases open through the roof of the tomb and provide light to the interior. Tall decorative spires extend from the edges of base walls and provide visual emphasis to the height of the dome. The main finial was originally made of gold but was replaced by a copy made of gilded bronze in the early 19th century. This feature provides a clear example of the integration of traditional Persian and Hindu decorative elements. The finial is topped by a moon, a typical Islamic motif whose horns point heavenward. The minarets, which are each more than 40 meters tall, display the designer's penchant for symmetry. They were designed as working minarets, a traditional element of mosques, used by the muezzin to call the Islamic faithful to prayer. Each minaret is effectively divided into three equal parts by two working balconies that ring the tower. At the top of the tower is a final balcony surmounted by a chhatri that mirrors the design of those on the tomb. The chhatris all share the same decorative elements of a lotus design topped by a gilded finial. The minarets were constructed slightly outside of the plinth so that in the event of collapse, a typical occurrence with many tall constructions of the period, the material from the towers would tend to fall away from the tomb. Exterior decorations. The exterior decorations of the Taj Mahal are among the finest in Mughal architecture. As the surface area changes, the decorations are refined proportionally. The decorative elements were created by applying paint, stucco, stone inlays, or carvings. In line with the Islamic prohibition against the use of anthropomorphic forms, the decorative elements can be grouped into either calligraphy, abstract forms, or vegetative motifs. Throughout the complex are passages from the Quran that comprise some of the decorative elements. Recent scholarship suggests that Aminat Khan chose the passages. The calligraphy on the Great Gate reads, "O soul, thou art at rest. Return to the Lord at peace with him, and he at peace with you." The calligraphy was created in 1609 by a calligrapher named Abdul Haq. Shah Jahan conferred the title of Aminat Khan upon him as a reward for his dazzling virtuosity. Near the lines from the Quran at the base of the interior dome is the inscription. Written by the insignificant being, Amanat Khan Shireza. Much of the calligraphy is composed of florid Thulic script made of jasper or black marble inlaid in white marble panels. Higher panels are written in a slightly larger script to reduce the skewing effect when viewed from below. Interior decoration. The interior chamber of the Taj Mahal reaches far beyond traditional decorative elements. The inlay work is not pietra dura, but a lapidary of precious and semi-precious gemstones. The inner chamber is an octagon with the design allowing for entry from each face, although only the door facing the garden to the south is used. The interior walls are about 25 meters high and are topped by a false interior dome decorated with a sun motif. 8 pishtak arches define the space at ground level and, as with the exterior, each lower pishtak is crowned by a second pishtak about midway up the wall. The 4 central upper arches form balconies or viewing areas, and each balcony's exterior window has an intricate screen or jolly cut from marble. In addition to the light from the balcony screens, light enters through roof openings covered by chatrais at the corners. The octagonal marble screen or jolly bordering the cenotaphs is made from 8 marble panels carved through with intricate pierce work. The remaining surfaces are inlaid in delicate detail with semi-precious stones forming twining vines, fruits, and flowers. Each chamber wall is highly decorated with dado bas relief, intricate lapidary inlay, and refined calligraphy panels which reflect, in little detail, the design elements seen throughout the exterior of the complex. Muslim tradition forbids elaborate decoration of graves. Hence, the bodies of Mumtaz and Shah Jahan were put in a relatively plain crypt beneath the inner chamber with their faces turned right, towards Mecca. Mumtaz Mahal cenotaph is placed at the precise center of the inner chamber on a rectangular marble base. Both the base and casket are elaborately inlaid with precious and semi-precious gems. Calligraphic inscriptions on the casket identify and praise Mumtaz. On the lid of the casket is a raised rectangular lozenge meant to suggest a writing tablet. Shah Jahan's cenotaph is beside Mumtaz's to the western side and is the only visible asymmetric element in the entire complex. His cenotaph is bigger than his wife's, but reflects the same elements, a larger casket on a slightly taller base precisely decorated with lapidary and calligraphy that identifies him. On the lid of the casket is a traditional sculpture of a small pen box. The pen box and writing tablet are traditional Mughal funerary icons decorating the caskets of men and women respectively. The 99 names of God are calligraphic inscriptions on the sides of the actual tomb of Mumtaz Mahal. Other inscriptions inside the crypt include, O Noble, O Magnificent, O Majestic, O Unique, O Eternal, O Glorious. The tomb of Shah Jahan bears a calligraphic inscription that reads, He traveled from this world to the banquet hall of eternity on the night of the 26th of the month of Rajab, in the year 1076 Hijri. Garden. The complex is set around a large 300-meter square Mughal garden. The garden uses raised pathways that divide each of the 4 quarters of the garden into 16 sunken flower beds. Halfway between the tomb and gateway in the center of the garden is a raised marble water tank with a reflecting pool positioned on a north-south axis to reflect the image of the mausoleum. The elevated marble water tank is called Al-Had Al-Kathar, about the tank of abundance promised to Muhammad. Elsewhere, the garden is laid out with avenues of trees labeled according to common and scientific names and fountains. The Charbagh Garden, a design inspired by Persian gardens, was introduced to India by Babur, the first Mughal emperor. It symbolizes the 4 flowing rivers of Jannah and reflects the paradise garden derived from the Persian paradizat, meaning walled garden. In mystic Islamic texts of the Mughal period, paradise is described as an ideal garden of abundance with 4 rivers flowing from a central spring or mountain, separating the garden into north, west, south, and east. Most Mughal charbaghs are rectangular with a tomb or pavilion in the center. The Taj Mahal garden is unusual in that the main element, the tomb, is located at the end of the garden. With the discovery of Mahtab Bagh or Moonlight Garden on the other side of the Yamuna, the interpretation of the Archaeological Survey of India is that the Yamuna River itself was incorporated into the garden's design and was meant to be seen as one of the rivers of paradise. Similarities in layout and architectural features with the Shalimar Garden suggest both gardens may have been designed by the same architect, Ali Martin. Early accounts of the garden describe its profusion of vegetation, including abundant roses, daffodils, and fruit trees. As the Mughal Empire declined, the Taj Mahal and its gardens also declined. By the end of the 19th century, the British Empire controlled more than 3/5 of India, and assumed management of the Taj Mahal. They changed the landscaping to their liking, which more closely resembled the formal lawns of London. Threats. Protective wartime scaffolding in 1942. In 1942, the government erected scaffolding to disguise the building in anticipation of air attacks by the Japanese Air Force. During the India-Pakistan Wars of 1965 and 1971, scaffolding was again erected to mislead bomber pilots. More recent threats have come from the environmental pollution on the banks of the Yamuna River, including acid rain due to the Mathura oil refinery, which was opposed by the Supreme Court of India. Directives? The pollution has been turning the Taj Mahal yellow-brown. To help control the pollution, the Indian government has set up the Taj Trapezium Zone, a 10,400 square kilometer area around the monument where strict emission standards are in place. Concerns for the tomb's structural integrity have recently been raised because of a decline in the groundwater level in the Yamuna River basin, which is falling at a rate of around 1.5 m per year. In 2010, cracks appeared in parts of the tomb, and the minarets which surround the monument were showing signs of tilting, as the wooden foundation of the tomb may be rotting due to lack of water. It has been pointed out by politicians, however, that the minarets are designed to tilt slightly outwards to prevent them from crashing on top of the tomb in the event of an earthquake. In 2011, it was reported that some predictions indicated that the tomb could collapse within 5 years. Tourism. The Taj Mahal attracts a large number of tourists. UNESCO documented more than 2 million visitors in 2001, which had increased to about 7 to 8 million in 2014. A two-tier pricing system is in place, with a significantly lower entrance fee for Indian citizens and a more expensive one for foreigners. In 2018, the fee for Indian citizens was 50 INR, for foreign tourists 1,100 INR. Most tourists visit in the cooler months of October, November, and February. Polluting traffic is not allowed near the complex and tourists must either walk from parking areas or catch an electric bus. The Kawaspuras are currently being restored for use as a new visitor center. In 2019, to address over-tourism, the site instituted fines for visitors who stayed longer than 3 hours. The small town to the south of the Taj, known as Taj Ganji or Mumtazabad, was initially constructed with caravanserais, bazaars, and markets to serve the needs of visitors and workers. Lists of recommended travel destinations often feature the Taj Mahal, which also appears in several listings of Seven Wonders of the Modern World. Including the recently announced new Seven Wonders of the World, a recent poll with 100 million votes. The grounds are open from 6 to 1900 hours on weekdays, except for Friday when the complex is open for prayers at the mosque between 12 o'clock and 1400 hours. The complex is open for night viewing on the day of the full moon and 2 days before and after, excluding Fridays and the month of Ramadan. Myths. Ever since its construction, the building has been the source of an admiration transcending culture and geography. And so personal and emotional responses have consistently eclipsed scholastic appraisals of the monument. A long-standing myth holds that Shah Jahan planned a mausoleum to be built in black marble as a black Taj Mahal across the Yamuna River. The idea originates from the fanciful writings of Jean-Baptiste Tavernier, a European traveler who visited Agra in 1665. It was suggested that his son Aurangzeb overthrew Shah Jahan before it could be built. Ruins of blackened marble across the river in Moonlight Garden, Mathab Bagh, seemed to support this legend. However, excavations carried out in the 1990s found that they were discolored white stones that had turned black. A more credible theory for the origins of the black mausoleum was demonstrated in 2006 by archaeologists who reconstructed part of the pool in the Moonlight Garden. A dark reflection of the white mausoleum could be seen, befitting Shah Jahan's obsession with symmetry and the positioning of the pool itself. No concrete evidence exists for claims that describe, often in horrific detail, the deaths, dismemberments and mutilations which Shah Jahan supposedly inflicted on various architects and craftsmen associated with the tomb. Some stories claim that those involved in construction signed contracts committing themselves to have no part in any similar design. Similar claims are made for many famous buildings. No evidence exists for claims that Lord William Bentinck, Governor General of India in the 1830s, supposedly planned to demolish the Taj Mahal and auction off the marble. Bentinck's biographer John Roselli says that the story arose from Bentinck's fundraising sale of discarded marble from Agra.